Boys and girls, welcome to my channel. I'm For Classic and welcome to Benchart. So for today, what I do have needed is Hellpoint, a game developed by the Cradle Games, and these guys are using Unity Engine to power up their game. So Cradle Games, this is their first game ever, and it seems that follows up a lot the Souls-like type of game, right? So yeah, this is kind of a Dark Souls in a dark science fiction environment. Alright, but we are here today to talk about the performance and how well or bad it runs on the NVIDIA MX130, which is the same thing as the GT940MX with GDDR5. So let's take a look on the settings. I had to go back to the main menu of the game, since you can't change the graphics inside the game. And as you can see, I'm playing with absolutely maximum settings over here, aside from, yeah, that. And I'm using TAA, and I'm playing with 720p. This is my personal preference. So looking to the minimum requirements, these guys ask for a GTX 760, 4GB of RAM, and a CPU with 4 threads, which at least 2.5GHz. So like the usual, I always test with 2 different settings. So I decided to test the game with 720p, with max out settings, the settings that I'm using in here, and I got an average of 45 and a minimum of 35. The low settings, which is pretty much the minimum settings, I got an average of 65, but the minimum of 45. Jumping up to 900p, the maximum settings runs below 30 frames per second at some occasions. So the low settings runs with averages of 51, with a 1% low of 33. If you decide to go with 1080p, even with the low settings, it is not enough to prevent the drops from 30 frames per second. So yeah. Probably not the best recommended resolution to go play this game with. Alright, so let's wrap all these results together, and this is all the results that I did gather. So my personal recommendation for you, if you want to play this game, it is to play with either 720p low or max, or 900p at low. 900p at max or 1080p at low, both of them run sometimes below 30 frames per second, and I can't really recommend, because this is pretty much the start of the game, and I'm not really sure how the scenarios will be forward into the game, so I'm not really sure if the game will be more demanding or less demanding, and so it is a little bit hard to recommend settings that are already dropping below 30 frames per second. And Hellpoint, yes, it is a tough game, since it tries to resemble Dark Souls, so it is its level of difficulty, so don't expect an easy game. And so because of that, I do think that frame rate, it is important. But I've been talking about the game being kind of similar to Dark Souls, so let's talk a little bit about Hellpoint. So Hellpoint, it is pretty much a Souls-like game, alright? So just like many other games this generation. But unfortunately for the developers, this game haven't been really well received. So on Metacritic, the score of this game, it is around 60, so it's a very low score in my opinion, and the Steam users are about 70% of score. So I mean, I've been playing a little bit of the game, and I don't think that the game it is that really bad. It's just uninspiring in my opinion, because for example the art style of this game, it is really bland. You just have like these corridors, these dark gritty science fiction corridors, and I have nothing against the fact that it is dark and it resembles the future hell-ish Doom style. I have nothing against that. I think it's great, but I mean the corridors itself, they lack detail. You know, it seems like they didn't put too much love into the level department. If you compare it to a Dark Souls or to the Surge, for example, there is a ton of detail on their levels. All right, they might be simple corridors, but they are populated with tons of details, which make them really great, all right. And unfortunately, what I do find about it, about Hellpoint, is that yes, it is lacking some detail. Most of the corridors are just, you know, simple corridors. Although the level designs are great, so there are multiple paths which you can take. There are kind of secret paths which you need to find in order to find stuff. So I think in that regard, in the level design department, it is great, but on the level art style, for example, I don't really enjoy that much. I think that they could have done so much better regarding to that.
Gameplay-wise, I do think that the gameplay works really well. I've been reading some comments on Steam page where people say that the combat it is clunky. I fully disagree, alright? I think that the combat it is responsive. On the worst case, what I do think that the combat might be a little bit clunky, it is when you are pressing to, like, to attack. Sometimes there are some sort of latency into it, where you kind of just want to attack 3 times, and at some point it just attacks 4 times for some reason, alright? It's like a latency, you press it so much times to attack that the game registers all the times, or almost all the times, that you press to attack. So it's the only downside that I have found so far. I think the combat works really well, and it is smooth enough, so I don't agree mostly with the comments that people are saying about the combat of this game. I think it works pretty well, and it's pretty surprising for a first project on by this studio. So yeah, it is good. Also, there is one good thing about this game is that it supports cooperative, so it works pretty much the same way as the Dark Souls. So you can summon your friends or other players to help you out with some of the bosses or help you out with the game. So I think in that regard, I think it is honestly pretty good. Because for example, the Surge, it is great, and I do love the Surge. It is a futuristic Dark Souls style game, but it is fully single player. While this game on the other hand, it allows you to go cooperative with your friends if you want. And above all, this game, it is not even expensive. It costs $29.99, so it's not an expensive price. It's like the developers exactly know that they don't have in your top tier product, so they can't really charge a full price for their game. And yeah, I think it's mostly that. But yes, the game just scored too low. I mean, the only downside I really see is really just the level art style. I think the rest of the game just works amazingly well. It is responsive, it is well optimized, but it is just uninspiring, alright? Same type of enemies, the same type of corridors all the time. So it is just, I don't know, it is just that, alright? But I think the price it is completely correct for the game. I think $29.99, it is a good price for what it offers. But it is hard to recommend, because if you have, for example, if you want something futuristic at Dark Souls style, you can buy The Surge, which is a great game if you want. So there are a ton of Souls-like games that are just better than this, more inspiring, more original, alright? And this one, it is just pretty much like a copy of the entire Dark Souls gameplay, Dark Souls / Bloodborne, and they kind of just build it into a dark science fiction environment, alright? It works great, but it is just uninspiring, alright? So I think that's all that I want to talk about the game. So I think it is a good game, honestly. If you already played The Surge, if you already played Dark Souls, and you want another Souls-like game to play, I think it is amazing, because it is not expensive, and again, it works well, everything it is fine with the game. Despite people say that it isn't, for me, it was perfect all the time. So it is just that. But if you never play The Surge, if you never play Dark Souls or any other game out there like Souls-like, probably you should play them first before going out and buy this game. Alright, so guys, I think that's all that I want to talk about Hellpoint. Hope you did enjoy the video, and I do hope to see you soon. Goodbye.